Well, Congressman Emanuel Cleaver made national headlines this week when he announced his support to start an impeachment inquiry of President Trump.
Congressman Emanuel Cleaver joins us now to talk more about this topic and more. So thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Good to be with you.
So what was it that made this final decision for you to support an impeachment inquiry?
It was a conversation that I had with Rich Nadler, the chair of the Judiciary Committee, with Nancy Pelosi standing right by. And I think Nadler is one of the smartest guys I've ever been around in my life. And he said to me, look, we're going to have an inquiry anyway in our committee. And he said, you may as well support the inquiry. And I said, well, why? And he explained to me that that's going to give us additional legal power to get documents we need, to maybe get underlying information that grand juries possess. And remember, we only saw the redacted portions of Robert Mueller's report. We have no idea what's in there. And we have none of the counterintelligence information, which deals with Russia and whatever the FBI and our intelligence community was looking at. We don't know what that is. Robert Mueller sent all of those non-related legal items to other jurisdictions, right, like the Southern District of New
Doesn't
York.
Doesn't Nadler have the right, though, to see the unredacted report in a secure room?
No.
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 Other leaders of Congress do for the Democrats?
No, no, no. No, nobody can see that. We can go in there to look at classified information, but not a grand jury testimony.
Which includes grand jury testimony, which is basically illegal now for it to be released, right?
That's right. It is illegal. But nobody's supposed to get that information, you know, because they would essentially be giving out information that could impact the lives of innocent people.
Right. So this inquiry would also allow for the pretty much forcing Don McGahn, the president's White House attorney, to give his testimony, right, before
yes.
Congress?
If we're asking for information because we are now considering a judicial process, impeachment is judicial, even though it doesn't involve a court. It is a judicial movement by Congress. And so there's no reason at all for anyone to decline. And then the courts are more likely to enforce our request.
What has the president done that you think warrants impeachment inquiry?
Well, I think it's important for me to say that impeachment inquiry is not impeachment.
Right. And it's not conviction.
That's right.
Right.
All it is a collection of information. And I think everybody realizes that Mueller has said repeatedly after the report, since the report, that he didn't clear the president. And we need to make sure that we constitutionally carry out our responsibility, which is to provide oversight to the executive branch of the government. And the president hasn't cooperated. That also bothered me a lot, that he's the only president in U.S. history who would not cooperate by sending his cabinet members to the committee.
Congressman Cleaver, a couple of weeks ago, it made national headlines that you dropped the gavel, you were fed up with Congress, you were fed up with the infighting. Is this something that has been building over the years for you, or is there something going on in Congress that is just exceptionally egregious as far as this lack of getting along?
Well, my youngest son, when he was a little boy, he used to say, use the word worser, you know, mm-hmm. Daddy, this is worser. Well, I think what I'm seeing now is worser. Mm-hmm. And I was asked to preside over a session because it was going to be, you know, contentious, and I generally get along with both sides. So mm-hmm. Nancy Pelosi asked me to conduct that particular meeting. And so I don't want to go into a lot of detail because it would be boring to the to the public. But essentially, all we were doing is moving toward a crescendo for chaos. Mm-hmm. And I frankly didn't want to be in a part of it. And I didn't realize that I was getting ready to do something that had never been done in 243 years. But I think I got the attention of everybody. People like Steve King of Iowa came by and high-fived me. People like Meadows, who leads the Freedom Caucus, used to be the Tea Party, came by and said, hey, you're right. both sides were coming saying, you know, that was not a good thing.
We're running out of time. I got to ask you about Elijah Cummings from Baltimore, from Maryland, a congressman, a friend of yours. This thing has really gotten explosive, the exchange between he and the president. And is the president a racist?
I don't call anybody a racist, even if I know deep down in my heart that they are. I don't do that, because once you call somebody a racist, you essentially shut the door. There's no communication.
Why are so many people calling the president a racist?
They believe him. They believe that he is racist, and they base that on things he's said and done. What I know that he does is continually make statements that are racially insensitive and hurtful, and I think people are afraid of what it's doing to the country. I am as well. It's tearing this country in two, and we're now getting phone calls all over the Congress, everybody is, that people weren't getting since the 1960s.
Last question, did you watch the debates last night?
I did not watch the debates.
Oh, you missed it.
Well, I'm not going to watch the debates at all. It's a little boring, and then I get frustrated. You know, I mean, I said, all he had to do was say this.
Right.
And so,
I got
watch.
You. We have two things in common. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you know this, but when I first moved here 21 years ago, you were mayor, and you were from Waxahachie, Texas.
Yes.
I'm also a native Texan, and we both thrift store shop.
That's right.
And you still shop at thrift stores.
I do. It's one of the best things that an American could do.
Oh, yeah.
And
you can find great stuff.
Yeah.
And you look great.
Yes. Yeah.
There you go.
And you need to go on vacation in Waxahachie.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I do. I spent 3.5 years in Texas, never went to Waxahachie. So.
Go to Collins Street Bakery, get a
I'll have to go back.
Fruitcake.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Congressman.